Hi, welcome to BarneyTech channel. Here we are going to see a small introduction about generator. If we see the working of generator, whenever the conductor cuts the magnetic field, it induces an EMF on it according to the Fleming's right hand rule. This is the theory. Now we are going to see the practical from the starting of the generator to the power connected to the grid. First we will see the layout of generating station. Main part of the generator is stator and rotor. On rotor, the magnetic field is produced with the help of exciter. On rotor, the rotating force is gained by turbine. So the rotor is mechanically coupled with turbine. The turbine speed is controlled by governor. The output power is get connected from the stator, which is connected to unit transformer and power transformer. From the power transformer, the power is connected to grid. Let us consider the generator is level kV. And the unit transformer is used for local power utilization. Now we will see how the generator produces power. First, the exciter DC supply is switched on. When the DC supply is given to the rotor produces magnetic field. And high pressure stream is given to turbine. The turbine speed controlled by the governor. From rotor, the magnetic flux is cut by stator winding and depend on the rotor speed, the voltage and frequency is produced on stator. Due to less speed, the stator produces only 2 kV and 20 Hz here. When the speed start to increase gradually, the voltage will also start to build up. When the generator reaches the rated speed, it will produce the rated voltage and frequency. When it reaches the rated voltage and frequency, then only we have to close the generator breaker. When the generator breaker get closed, the unit transformer and power transformer get power supply. To close grid breaker, we have to check synchronizing between grid and power transformer. Once the synchronizing relay give permissive, then only we can able to close the grid breaker. And the power from the generator is connected to grid. Now we energize the generator and it will start to run. During this period, the various fault may occurs, mainly due to stator winding fault, rotor fault and abnormal operation condition on outside of the generator. To protect the generator, I have shown some of the production here. They are thermal overload, unbalance, overcurrent earth fault, overvoltage, undervoltage, overfrequency, underfrequency, overexcitation or overflux, underexcitation, rotor earth fault, stator earth fault, pole slip, low forward, reverse power, backup impedance, dead machine and differential production. Due to this fault, the generator will give trip to following generator, turbine, power transformer and unit transformer. And also the relay is classified as trip. They are class A, class B and class C. On next video we will see about class A, class B and class C trip and also why we use these classes. By this we came to the end of this section. Be safe. See you on next video. If you like this section, then please share to your friends and colleagues. Take care and bye from BarneyTech channel. Thank you for watching this video.